The trial is looking at using lower rates of residual herbicide in the interrow while maintaining efficacy of controlling weeds. We used a commonly used residual and knockdown herbicide in the interrow, looking at different application methods. So for this, we used a flat boom, the Irvin 6 nozzle spray bar, as well as the dual herbicide sprayer, or DHS. So for each application method, the rates that we've used were 100%, 60% and 30%. To get those rates, we adjusted the centre nozzle on each boom. So we were able to reduce the output for the interrow to 60% for our medium rate and 30% for the low rate. So the flat boom treatment was applied mid-October, just following harvest. And due to the challenging weather conditions that we faced, the DHS and Irvin treatments were applied mid to late November, which meant that the weeds were a lot more established. The coverage that we got, particularly on the nut grass, was not as good as what we'd hoped to have got. We conducted weed counts prior to the application of the DHS and Irvin spray bar to get an idea of weed populations. What we found was there was quite high populations of nut grass and wild rose, and there was lower scattered populations of blue top and guinea grass. The flat boom treatment started with a zero weed population. When we did that first weed count, we noticed an increase in the broadleaf weeds, the nut grass and guinea grass. They were still relatively low, but we were starting to see an increase. Subsequent weed counts that were done showed quite good control of the weeds in the row itself, with a really good suppression of nut grass in the interrow. Final weed counts were carried out mid-January, 8 weeks after the application of the DHS and the Irvin spray bar treatments. What we saw was there was quite high populations in the flat boom treatments. Originally it had quite good control, but as the cane's grown on, the weeds have come through. Got some blue top back here, there's a bit of wild rose and a few other broadleaves, and they're all quite well established. Probably be looking at coming back in so that they were not competing with your cane. In the DHS and Irvin spray bar treatments, we had new germinations of weeds, but they were a lot lower, and because the cane is so much more advanced now, they weren't competing with the cane and the cane was shading them out. So this is the Irvin spray bar at the lower rate, 30% residual herbicide applied to the interrow. We're still seeing a bit of nut grass, but it's not growing very actively. So this is a DHS low rate treatment. So we've got a few nut grass here that have grown through the herbicide treatment. They were really well established at the time of application, so I'm really pleased with how clean that this treatment's come up. What we're seeing in the trial to date, the DHS and the Irvin spray bar look to be the better application methods, and using a low dose of residual herbicide in the interrow, we're getting a similar weed control to what we would be if we were using the full rate. By delaying the application of your herbicide until the cane is growing actively and your weeds have germinated, you'll be able to make a more informed decision on what herbicide is suitable for your particular block and your weed spectrum that you've got present. So we'll be looking to establish additional trials in the coming year to further investigate this technique of using lower dose rates of residual herbicides in the interrow, because this looks like it could be a viable tool to be able to better manage weeds and be profitable for growers in the long term.